Morning.
Hey ho, hey ho. I just like doing that. Silly, really. Ah, morning, John Hill here. It's Monday, the 23rd of May, 2022, and we're getting close to the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. No other monarch has ever reigned for such a length of time in Britain. And so that's coming up this weekend, so I'm going over to Bedworth to have a look at what's going on there.
As I make my way past the Pingles Athletics track in Nuneaton, I'll just explain what's happening in Bedworth, which is the small town in our borough of Nuneaton and Bedworth. David Best, an American sculptor, has been commissioned to build a temporary building of sanctuary out of fretwork and plywood, and is there to commemorate all those who have suffered and died because of the pandemic caused by COVID-19. The construction has just been finished and the public can view it this week before it gets burned to the ground on Saturday. At this point, I'm going to leave the main road and take the towpath next to the Coventry Canal, and that will take me all the way to Bedworth. Stop for a moment and wonder at the magnificence of cow parsley. It's sculpturally so wonderful, as all the flowers with those beautiful heads on the top. Just go into all the spaces in three dimensions with these beautiful delicate stalks. If you're not interested in this, you can just jump on ahead because you obviously have no soul. And if this one plant wasn't enough, there's all these, look. There's lots of them. Millions of them in the countryside. I love them. Well, up ahead, that's a chiff chaff, by the way, chiff chaff. Up ahead, visual chaos, look at it. Let's have a closer look. I've just seen a sign which calls itself Charity Dock. Well, I'm gonna stop here and just pass a comment about these sorts of places. The canals are used by middle class, you know, fairly well off holiday people. But there's also a number of people who are seeking a sort of an alternative lifestyle. And this is the sort of thing you'll get. And why not? I think it's fascinating. Well, this is the navigation pub on the Balkington Road. Looks like a house now. That's a house. That is substantial. At last, my setting off point, which will be up here. I'm in Bedworth now, and this is the Miners Welfare Park. And this is a monument to the Armistice Day Parade, which is one of the most famous ones in Britain. And I can see here they've got a Ukrainian flag up as well. But the main entrance is just up here. Well, this park was first put together in the 1920s for the benefit of the miners.
and there's a lot of coal mining in this area, and it's a tough life, and this is an important facility for them.
Well, I may be 70 years old, but sometimes I feel like a 7-year-old. Look at this cycleway. I just love to have a go on there. Right, there's a building here called Sanctuary. It's made of wood. And it's going to get burned next week. Is it okay if I film this to put it on my YouTube channel?
Sure, of course it is.
Thank you very much indeed.
Yeah,
this
is
a magnificent piece of work, sir.
Yeah, it's a fun piece, isn't it?
It sounds, it looks a little bit Eastern, Far Eastern.
It's just a mixture of everything from Victorian graphics to, you know, just anything. It's all a mixture.
Yeah.
You know, it's just so that... people think that's what it is, you know. They think it's a sacred space, so you kind of make it look like one.
Absolutely. I think you've done it.
I was very grateful to Mr. Best for answering these questions, but as you can see, he was slightly distracted by the concerns of the disabled group of people who had just been given access to the building. This is Adrian, who was one of the team that helped construct the Sanctuary building.
So whose initiative was this? From the council, is it?
I don't think it's the council. I think it's an arts funded project. Who instigated it, I'm not too sure.
Right.
But there's a collaboration between Artichoke, Imagineer, Unusual and Royal Shakespeare Company come together to put it.
Yeah, I see.
That's about all I know.
Yeah. Thank you.
there we have it, the sanctuary building, which is going to be burned, set afire on Saturday, I do believe. Yeah, should be quite a spectacle.